You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com.
Hi, I'm Mary Poplin with BorisFX, and we're going to talk about PowerMesh workflows. So now that we have all of the data that we need, it's time to take it out of Mocha and use it inside of After Effects. We're going to talk about a couple of ways we can use the mesh warp, mats, and our dense tracking output. We can also export our PowerMesh as an alembic mesh data. This file can be used in things like Cinema 4D, Maya, Nuke, Fusion, and more. See our website for detailed breakdowns of those workflows. In After Effects, we're going to use something called a stabilized workflow. So we're going to go to our stabilize module and select our t-shirt track. We're going to find our frame where we were nice and flat, and we're going to add that to our frame list. We can also use the align surface tool to create this same effect, but in this case, we're going to use a frame list. We're picking this frame where our shirt is the most parallel to camera. So we're going to select mesh warping, unwarp, and use our mats. And now if I scrub through my shot, I can see that my shirt is pinned into place. This is exactly what we want. Let's hit save. And it will take a minute to save because we're saving a very dense mesh data. And once our save is complete, we're going to hit close. Let's duplicate our background layer. And let's start to finish this shot. If I want to stabilize this shot, I'm going to click Module Renders, select Stabilize Unwarp, and click the Render checkbox. Now my shot is stabilized. And my mat is front and center because I used the mat in my stabilize. I'm going to layer and pre-compose this. We're going to move all of the attributes into the new composition. I'm going to call this Stabilized Shirt and double-click to open up the pre-comp. I'm going to create a shape layer and change the color. Using my selection tool, I'll place this how I like. I'm going to create a solid and use my shape layer as an alpha mat. And using After Effects native tools, I'll add a little bit of a grain to the star. Using a dissolve blend, I'm going to break up the edges of this and turn my background stabilized layer off. Back in my After Effects file, I'm going to copy my original Power Mesh effect and paste it onto my stabilized shirt layer. I'm going to select Stabilize Warp and Render. And I can check and make sure in draft quality that that's rendering back to my timeline. Now, inside of my stabilize, my mat is applied. So we're going to launch Mocha. And in our stabilize, we're going to turn off use mat and save and close. Now my star is applied throughout my shot. Now with a quick soft light and a quick box blur, we have a star t-shirt. Or we could paint in our stabilized pre-comp. There are many, many ways that we can use this data to warp and unwarp objects to our scene. And as for how to apply PowerMesh mats, it's the same as any other mat application inside of Mocha. You can either view the mat, apply the mat, or create AE masks. And that's how you work with PowerMesh data for a stabilized pre-comp. In this exercise, we talked about stabilized workflows inside of After Effects, using the stabilized data, and destabilizing the warp. Now Ben Brownlee is going to walk you through the Stabilize module.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version, available at borisfx.com.